to 2008 coverage now. Voters in Live Oak are set to decide on a measure to help schools. It is Measure A, an $84 a year parcel tax to fund programs at Live Oak schools.
Action News reporter Robbie Kapoor shows us what's at stake there.
So there really is nothing left to cut. You know, we're down to, you know, to skin and bone.
8 years of state budget cuts have the Live Oak School District in a major bind. Education is highly valued in this four-square-mile unincorporated part of Santa Cruz, and schools are at the heart of this community. So Measure A was placed on the ballot to allocate revenue for programs that are usually the first to go.
And without the parcel tax, we unfortunately will lose our art and music programs in our elementary schools, and the ones in our middle and high school will have to be cut back, and our libraries will unfortunately have to be scaled back.
At $84 per year per parcel, or $7 a month, Superintendent David Payne believes the tax on district residents is a small price to pay to maintain art, music, library, and science programs he says are essential for student growth.
And as I said, our librarian is only here in the morning, that we don't have enough funding for her to be here the entire school day.
Oh, my sound, she is a maiden band, singing holly, holly, do all the day.
Greg Brown teaches music to 500 fourth and fifth graders throughout the district. Most of the kids receive their first exposure to modern and classic tunes in this classroom, so it really becomes a lesson in perseverance, something that stays with students for a lifetime.
And when they do finally learn, they're just extremely proud of themselves. And to allow students to have pride in themselves over the work they put in, that's what makes me really proud.
A parcel tax for roughly $10 per month, known as Measure P, won support in the Santa Cruz City School District last year. It was the second such tax passed by community members. Santa Cruz City School Board member Rachel Dewey Thorson says the guaranteed funding led directly to smaller class sizes and better results in the classroom.
We've seen quite significant growth in, if you measure student achievement by test scores, quite significant growth in test scores over the past 4 years, both in the elementary schools and the middle schools.
The students from Live Oak eventually migrate to the same high schools as Santa Cruz City kids, so ensuring they receive the same instruction from start to finish is Superintendent Payne's top priority.
Yeah, so what was the solution to the problem?
It was her birthday and they gave her a little...
Yeah, that was a good way of solving that problem, wasn't it?
Yep.
It's such a small investment, $7 a month, to keep these essential programs going.
An investment in the Central Coast's future. In Santa Cruz, Ravi Kapoor, KSBW, Action News 8.
Wow, you guys learned that song.
There is no formal opposition to the proposed tax, which does have exemptions for seniors. If passed, Measure A is expected to raise $450,000 over the next 9 years for the school district.